Today we're gonna be discussing updating your resume because honey, what worked 5 years ago is not working right now. So I'm gonna be sharing everything that you need to know when it comes to updating your resume. Welcome to Moms and Money, where we talk about managing money, making money, and saving money for the women in the household. So I'm starting a new series on my channel called Career Control. I had such a great response when I asked you guys if you wanted to see videos on updating your resume or trying to find a new career or a new job. So many of you said that you wanted to see it. In this series, we're gonna go over updating your resume, interviewing tips, how to change careers or get back in the workforce. If you took time off to take care of a family member or start a family, we're gonna be discussing all of those things. So if you're into that kind of stuff or just personal finance as a whole, you definitely wanna subscribe, hit the like button and join my YouTube family. So many things have changed with resumes since I first started in my corporate career 15 years ago and now. So many things have changed. The style and template of resumes changes so often that it's kind of sometimes hard to keep up, especially if you like to change jobs every year or every 2 years, every 5 years. So many things have changed, especially since LinkedIn has come in and been a big heavy hitter when it comes to finding jobs, recruitment, and anything like that. So let me tell you about me personally. I worked in corporate America for over 15 years, everything from being a junior accountant all the way up to like a senior business analyst. Now, I'm not claiming to be an expert in HR, but I have interviewed quite a bit over the years, everything from junior positions to management of an entire department. And I've seen some really, really stellar, great resumes, and I've seen some really crappy ones. So today I'm gonna share with you how to really update your resume, keep it fresh, especially if this is your first time looking for a job in a while, or maybe you've been in your position for a while and you know, you just don't know where to start when it comes to updating your resume, or maybe you've been out of the workforce completely and you're trying to get back in. I'm just gonna share some tips on what you can do to keep your resume abreast to the different changes and the different styles out there. Now, what I share today may not work for different industries like, you know, graphic design or photography or something where it's like freelance work that you're looking for. What I know is just about like more of a corporate professional environment. And so these tips today are gonna work for that type of job as opposed to maybe your portfolio or you're trying to find freelance work, or if it's a completely different industry outside of corporate America. Now there's so many different styles of resumes out there, you guys, it's hard to keep up. But me personally, I like just a basic plain style, nothing too complicated, nothing that's going to distract the eye from the things that you want your resume to be. And to be honest, you guys, it's hard to get your resume in front of an actual person these days. It's not like it used to be where someone in HR or a recruiter is looking at all the resumes that have applied to a certain position. It's not like that anymore. It's actually very digitized. Resumes are automatically screened by different algorithms and AI programs before they actually get to a physical person, okay? And I'll talk about that later on in the video, but just keep that in mind. So if your resume makes it to a physical person to actually see, you want it to be in the best shape possible. You want it to be very clean. You want the eyes to be drawn to what you want the person to read. You don't want it to be cluttered. You don't want too many lines on there. Just keep it very basic. Now, me personally, I like a clean resume style where it's your name and contact information at the top, then your education after that. Now, with education, you only want to put your higher education on there because it's already assumed that you graduated from high school. So you don't need to put that necessarily on there. And I'm gonna be sharing in another video 5 things not to put on your resume. But you don't need to put your high school education on there. Typically, you just put your higher education on there. After education, I typically like to have like a career profile underneath there. Now I'm talking to someone who has some experience. Now if you don't necessarily have experience, or maybe this is your first job that you're trying to find, or this is maybe a junior position or an internship, then you can completely skip this this section here. If you've been in the industry a couple of years, at this point, you should be able to have something to put as your career profile. It doesn't have to be anything extensive. Now, what I like to typically put on there is just the things that you're really good at. Maybe you save the company some money. Maybe you hit your sales goals every single time. If you can quantify your qualifications in this section, that is liquid gold on a resume. And I'll talk about quantifying your qualifications in detail later on, but this is where you would want to put that at. Maybe you're excellent at verbal communication. Maybe you're excellent at a certain software that you use, and this software, you used it to really help your department somehow. I mean, I'm trying to make it general, but you have to really do whatever it is specific to your industry. If you don't know what that is, then you need to start reading more articles about what's going on in your industry. You need to do job searches for the position that you want and see what companies are looking for in detail. See what they're looking for and try to gain that experience somehow in the current position that you have. Now, if you've been out of the workplace for a while, maybe you started a family or you had to take some time off for personal reasons, whatever that may be, you still wanna put this in there. So whatever you did before this, before you took your leave or your time off, you definitely still wanna put information in this section for whatever your previous position was. Again, if this is your first time in the workforce, or this is your first time in this position, or it's an internship or whatever, then you just wanna skip this section altogether. Also, make sure you just put bullet points, like long sentences and paragraphs. That's out. Nobody does that anymore. And it's hard, like people, they just don't have the attention span that they used to. So you want to keep it to short, sweet bullet points in this section. And actually you want to keep all the sections to bullet points with exception to your name and your contact info at the top. You want to put bullet points for everything else in your resume. You don't want to have long drawn out sentences or long paragraphs. That's just too much for people to read. People just don't have time to read like that anymore. So after the career profile, you want to put your experience. This is where you put where you've worked at, how long you worked there, the dates in between that you worked there, and then you bullet point your experience in detail for everything that you've done. Now it doesn't have to be a drawn out detail. You know, you wanna kinda get straight to the point of what you were responsible for. So for example, let's say you're an accountant, and when you did accounting, maybe you did bank recs, or you audited, or you did some data analytics, or you did fixed assets, or whatever you did in detail for those sections, you wanna put in bullet points under your experience. So what I suggest to you all, if you're currently working somewhere and you've been working on different projects, you need to keep a folder in Outlook or in your email system that you're gonna use to put all of your experience in this folder. So anything that you've done, anytime you've got a great job from your boss, or any accolades that you've gotten, you wanna keep this stuff in a folder, electronic folder somewhere, so that you have this saved when it's time for you to look for another job. Because maybe you don't plan on looking for another job for another 2 to 3 years or 5 years. You have to remember all the things that you've done, and it's hard to at times. So you wanna keep some sort of folder somewhere where you can put emails in there, you can put like project descriptions in there, so you know exactly what you're working on. So this is where you put that kind of experience at in this section of your resume. You just wanna put, you know, your job, the company, the title, the dates that you worked there, and then the experience after that. Again, in all bullet points. After that, I like to put a computer skills section. This is where you put everything, all the software that you use, or any hardware that you use. It just depends on the position that you're looking for. Any CMS software, anything in Microsoft Office, from Outlook to Access to SQL, if you're into computer programming, any programming languages that you know, anything that pertains to the position that you want needs to go in this section, okay? So again, the best thing for you to do when it comes to updating your resume, look online for the positions that you want. Maybe you want that senior position. Maybe you want that management position. Maybe you wanna like shift roles a little bit and do something a little bit different. You need to be looking at what you want. Look at the experience that they're looking for. Look at the experience that they're requesting or requiring for the jobs as far as software goes, because it's typically something that you need to use, whether it's JD Edwards, Hyperion. I mean, there are so many different softwares out there that people use or companies use, and typically they want somebody who has this experience. Now, if your job, say your job doesn't use any of the software that you see on all these job descriptions, well, then you could take it upon yourself to invest in some sort of course or something online. You can pretty much YouTube anything when it comes to different softwares and how to use them. So I would definitely take some courses. I would educate myself online, you know, free, of course, if you can find it, or maybe you wanna spend a few bucks to learn. But if you do that, you can then add that you've used this software, that you have a little experience with this software in the computer skills section. And so that's a good way to get past the algorithm or the AI that looks at your, that, you know, kind of scrubs all the resume to look for people who have those keywords. And we'll talk about that a little bit later on in the video. Now that we talked about resume style, let's talk about quantifying your qualifications and what that means. Basically, that means how you performed in your position, if you can. So I know not every position is like that, but if you were in a position of, let's say, sales, and you hit your quarterly sales goal of X amount of dollars every year, you wanna put the amount of money that you hit in sales every year, because that's impressive. You know, you can't just say, I hit my quarterly sales goal every quarter, and that's it. If you put, I hit my quarterly sales goal of $100,000 every quarter, then the number will draw the eye of the recruiter or the manager, whoever's looking at your resume. It'll draw the eye and say, hey, wow, okay, they hit their numbers every month, that's cool. Or maybe you were in a position where you saved the company money X amount of dollars with the procedures that you came up with, or the policies that you come up with, or anything like that. Anytime you could quantify your qualifications, that's a huge plus. Now, I know that that doesn't work for every industry. I mean, maybe you're a teacher or a fireman or a policeman, and for resumes like that, I'm sorry, I really don't have any advice for that, because again, I've only worked in corporate America. But in corporate America, if you could quantify your qualifications, that's a huge plus. Okay, so the last thing I'm gonna talk about are keywords, okay? So you're probably thinking, well, what are keywords? Keywords are the words that will trigger the algorithm or the robot, whatever you wanna call it, that is scanning these resumes automatically when you apply. Those keywords are what will make you get in front of a human being to look at your resume. Okay, so for example, let's say this is an accounting position and they're looking for someone with experience with JD Edwards, who has experience with bank recs, who has experience with fixed assets. I'm just guessing right now. And let's say you're an accountant, but you don't have any of those words on your resume anywhere. You don't have fixed assets, you don't have JD Edwards, you don't have bank recs anywhere on your resume. You will not have an opportunity to get interviewed for this position, or the interviewer or the recruiter won't even see your resume at all, because the algorithm, or the machine, I like to call it, it's just going to say, put you in a reject pile because you don't have those keywords on your resume. That's why I said it's important to look at the job descriptions of the positions that you want and make sure you have those keywords on your resume somewhere. Now, I'm not saying to lie on your resume. Of course, we don't want to do that, because you can get yourself in trouble, for one, and for two, usually the recruiter can see right through that. Okay, so it has to make sense. Let's just put it that way. Maybe you have experience with bank recs, but you don't have experience with JD Edwards or fixed assets. Well, that's a plus, because then you at least have one of the keywords on there, and it's a possibility that the AI is going to put you in a maybe or a yes pile, as opposed to an automatic reject. So when I say keywords are crucial, keywords are key. If you don't have the right keywords on your resume will never get in front of HR or recruiter or human being, period. You're just gonna get automatically rejected. So maybe you've been applying to different jobs and you're just not hearing back. Don't feel bad, or don't feel bad about yourself. Don't take it personally or feel like you're not good enough, because that's not the case. Usually your resume just has never been in front of a human being in order for you to even possibly get that interview or even have an opportunity to interview for the position. So you just have to twerk your resume so that you can at least get in front of a human being. And then once you get in, get your foot in the door and you're able to interview, then that's your chance to really sell yourself. Another thing that you need to do for your resume is to convert it to a PDF. Okay, don't keep it in the Word document form. Once you are done updating your resume and it looks really, really good and you're comfortable with it, definitely convert it to a PDF. Not everybody has Microsoft Office, even though most most of corporate America does have Microsoft Office. Some people may actually work in the Apple world. So you definitely want to just keep it at a PDF so that they can just open a PDF. It's easier to open, it's cleaner. You don't have to worry about different versions of Word and stuff like that. So you definitely want to convert it to a PDF. There are definitely free ways to do that online. You can Google that quickly. I don't think you have to have any updated software, but definitely correct me down below if I'm wrong. But as far as I know, you can do that for free to convert a Word document into a PDF. Now, what you can't do for free is convert a PDF into Excel or Word or something like that. I know you have to pay for that, but to convert something to a PDF, I believe that is free to just do on your computer. So definitely do that because, again, it's easier for the person on the other side to just open the document easily. Something else that we're gonna discuss in a future video is LinkedIn. LinkedIn is a completely different animal. So we'll talk about that in a future video, and definitely leave comments down below for requests, video requests, or questions that you may have. Let's discuss. Maybe you are a recruiter or you are a hiring manager. Leave any tips that you have in the comments and let's have an open discussion. Now, I want to talk to any of you that maybe took time off for leave or FMLA, or maybe you started a family and that's wonderful. If that has happened to you, or maybe you've been a stay-at-home parent for X amount of years and now you're trying to get back in the workforce. Now, if this is you, you definitely need to put that experience that you gained while you took that time off. I'm sure you gained some sort of experience. I mean, raising children alone is like, whoa. It's life changing. I mean, you talk about managing time, managing resources. Like seriously, you have to be an expert at that just to, you know, get your kids from point A to point B, to keep them fed, to keep your house run properly. Trust me, I know it is a job and a half. So you want to try to find a way, depending on what industry you want to get into, try to find a way to incorporate some of that experience into your career profile. I definitely suggest that. You know, maybe you started learning about Google Ads, or maybe you started learning about Google Analytics or anything. I mean, we can learn anything. Everything is at our fingertips right now, you guys. That's the good thing. So if you're wanting to get into a new industry, maybe you want to learn how to code SQL. So many lessons, so many courses. I mean, even on YouTube for free on how to write SQL queries, something like that. Or maybe you need to learn Excel or Microsoft Word or PowerPoint better. There are channels that are dedicated just to teaching you that. So if you take the time to really educate yourself, all of that stuff can be put on your resume, guys. It does not have to just be experience from a job, you know, in corporate America. I mean, you can have real life experiences. Maybe you educated yourself during that time, and all of that experience needs to be put on your resume somehow. So don't get discouraged. Don't get overwhelmed. Maybe you're looking at different positions and you're like, oh my gosh, I don't have that kind of experience. Listen, you never know what opportunities that you can have if you don't try. Okay, so try to update your resume as much as you can. Try to add those keywords in so that you can get in front of a human person. You know, even if that means, like I said, you taking those courses or you educating yourself somehow, even if it means that, still add it on your resume so that you can at least get the opportunity to meet with someone face to face. Okay, so definitely stay encouraged. Don't think that you're not good enough. If a job says you have to have 3 to 5 years experience and maybe you only have 1 to 2 years, apply for that job, y'all. I'm telling you, apply for the job. And contrary to what popular belief, everybody gets on job training. Okay, you could have all the experience in the world, but you're still gonna get trained on how to do whatever it is that you wanna do for that specific company. Okay, everybody comes in at the same level. Everybody has to do some sort of training, okay? Now don't get me wrong, as the years progress and you get more experience, you know, maybe you can learn a little bit quicker, your learning curve is a lot quicker, or you know, you can bring new technologies or new procedures in with you, but at the end of the day, everybody gets trained on how to do certain things at a specific job. So again, stay encouraged. Don't let some of the requirements on these jobs deter you from at least trying. You've got to at least try. So in the next video, guys, I'm going to be talking about 5 things not to put on your resume, okay? Because I've seen some crazy ones in my past. Leave a comment down below and let me know if you have any questions about resumes. Are you currently looking for a job? Are you currently looking for a complete career change? Leave a comment down below and let me know what are your thoughts on that. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you haven't hit that subscribe button yet, you can tap my picture up above, and you can also check out my previous video right over here, and all of my social media platforms all listed down below. Thank you guys so much for watching. watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.